minutes of practice here.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Yay, sinking!
What's up?
Oh. Yay, rolling start, remember guys, don't go off the green.
That's good. Some of us have had me sinking.
Yo, what?
Mine is sinking.
The pit box.
Yeah, so.
Oh, stop sinking now. I got lads now.
Ah, it works.
So the number of people joining the silver race is just practice. Well, I feel like it's only league races, league drivers actually right now, because there's so much many people that's joining. As you can see, we're 25 right now.
No.
Is it started?
So yeah, I'm 22.
Oh, I'm out then.
Oh, there's a dead car on the left. Dead car on the left. Enzo is parked. Yeah. Oh, net rip.
Yeah, project cars, isn't it great?
What was happening to your car?
It just, when the race started, there was no cars on the grid. It shone a camera underneath the map, and now I'm stuck in the pit box.
Oh wow.
Yeah, Kodiak's fucked too, he had the same problem. He just
what the hell just happened?
Yes, I just went off.
Nice try, desk for your knick-knack. Yeah, what happened to you? Look weird. You just suddenly went to the right from me.
Yeah, same.
Guys, what the hell just happened?
Basically, you're a knick-knack. That's what you are. Yeah, I was pondering whether or not I can test my skills. These guys, well, I feel like you can try and sign up because the way I remember it, League Racers is getting priority.
Yeah.
And then everyone else can still try and join. Shut up, Desky, you're the same. But yeah, League Racers are getting priority, and I feel like other people can still join. I'm not sure, actually. The thing is, we have these rolling starts, and some people are ambitious and don't know how to read and stuff. There's a fly in my mind, so piss off.
Circuit, so.
Oh, you're a knick-knack.
Oh, wrong track.
Yeah, exactly. So I only found out we're racing with this circuit when we're in here.
I need some brake temperature now. Hey, Miss, I feel like we should just try and slot into the places that opens up to us.
What?
I think, yeah, because some cars left in the middle of everything, so we don't have open gaps.
Yeah.
I think you're supposed to go right, I need to go left.
In NFT, you want to be on the left hand side. It's on team
seat. Desk, you're an imbecile.
I'm gonna get going then, guys, anyways. You know, it's booked me out, I can't race.
Yeah, see you tomorrow, man. I'm better.
Now I'm getting ready for this formation. I feel like there was a gap up there somewhere. People are really bad at going the speed they're supposed to though. That was a bad start. See, Hamish is there somewhere. Let's see if I can cheat him out here. And get a bit of that nice live streaming thing. There's for your name, Basil. Sorry, Groby. Those missing brake marks are really costing me a lot. It's actually really so fucking annoying that we're making those breaking markers, like, honestly. I don't understand how people can take them the fuck out. Like, seriously, what's wrong with people? There was a dead car. That was a Hamish crashing into things.
I think he's got aero damage because he's going very slow around the corners.
Damage is off, so.
It's off?
Yeah, it should be.
Oh, fantastic, right, nice guy, come alongside me, I'm gonna hit you off.
Nah, no, piss off, you knick-knack. You wanna get hit off?
No.
I'm just gonna be bump drafting you a bit now.
Oh my god.
Oh, why is that braking mark always missing? Seriously. Nah, this is actually a little bullshit.
Told you I'd be here, Hamish.
Yeah, I know. We always seem to be in a battle though, even on qualifying, we're always battling.
It's such bullshit. It's bullshit that those big markers miss. I really need them so bad. That was a weird line he took down. Duncan, it's not Duncan, it's Drift King. I'm the Drift King. The king of drifting wide. I feel like the cars behind me had an instant or something. Let's just try and follow these two knobs here. That is my mission for today. The mission for today is at least, indeed, it is. Fly, stop crawling on my fucking monitor, you absolute imbecile. I hate this cone, I don't know why. I can't get a good line. If I go wide like they do, I just keep going wide and die. I feel like it's because I want to take too much speed through it. I want to be in an open wheel up with downforce. I want to be in a proper car, not this snake nugget. Why am I going out here? Why am I going sideways out here, especially? Hamish, you're not supposed to extend that corner.
No, I really messed it up. It's got 10 loads
there. Alright, come on. Let's remember where the brake markers are right now. There. Kinda. Rip. Yeah, champ in the making, exactly. Exactly, a champ in the making. Well, not really, though, I'm bad. I'm slow. I'm still driving with some of the fastest drivers in the world, and we don't want to go wide like that. This can go so wrong. I'm just going to break off on this. And let these two knickknacks fuck up. Wow, he missed.
Ooh.
I was out there. And I got a penalty. This game, you're imbecile.
I was trying to switch back, it just went into you.
You cost me a penalty, you knickknack. Just keep going though, it's fine. Yeah, but Deska, you can't really do all that spamming because you're an imbecile, because my bot is just gonna kill you. Yeah, exactly, Hamish, what the fuck? Piss off, fly, stop! Seriously, this fly keeps landing on my arm, on my hand, it's so fucking annoying. And I tried to kill it earlier, so... Yeah, I mean, I don't really care about Hamish, I wrecked him many times. Like, not killed him, wrecked him, but I just won over him because I was faster than him. Okay, now there's two flies! Great! I love flies! Now, the drinking time.
You have to reduce optimum water radiator slightly.
Oh, Hamish, what did you do?
Oh, we met again, Vice Guy.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Oh, God.
Well, that's my race.
What happened?
Oh, Nick.
And they just spun in front of me and I clicked him.
I know, so I was talking to Vice Guy.
Alright.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I kind of touched. Ghost touched you or something, so my car got flipped, bounced out, and got a 15 second penalty.
Well, someone just drove off the track.
I want to drive off the track.
No, that was me. I lost it.
Oh, right, okay. It just looked
cut
like
track this, yeah, honestly.
Your wheel went onto
seriously,
the
floor. What was the point of that cut track, yeah. Seriously? That cut track, seriously. Oh, logic. Yeah, exactly, logic. That was bullshit. That makes no sense, this cut track penalties. Like, I've gotten two so far, both by contact with Hamish, funnily enough. One of them was out here, going a bit wide. Honestly, I'm going wide, I'm not Yeah, honestly, I don't understand why they haven't just taken all the wide lines in the game, that you can clearly see them, around every fucking track, all over the place. And just said, this is the invisible wall, if you cross this with four wheels, you're dead. Easy peasy. But nope. That was apparently too complicated, so they just decided to randomly say, this is a corner, but this is not. Because let's say we can easily do this. There's no. There's not. Okay, it was legal this time, of course it was. Nah, the Nord's Life. I think after this race tomorrow we have 1 or 2 weeks break, I think it is, and then we have the Nord's Life race. Which is gonna be fucking ignoble race, won't it? I hate this. I hate these penalties. Seriously. Shut up! That was a nice demonstration if the game actually decided to not be an imbecile and ignore. I just thought my engine died. It just sounded like the car died. I was just getting scared. No, don't want to go wide. See, this is exactly why you should never go wide, extend or cut. Very easy to just avoid it. Because sometimes the game is a knickknack and sometimes it's not. Wait, practice for what? The Nord's Life? Nah, I'm scared. That's going to be one race I'm actually going to practice a lot for, and that's going to be a hardcore practice. With my friend AJ in the middle of the night like idiots. Because that's what we do. Actually, it's usually in the afternoon we do it, or in the morning actually. That's usually when he's not on work or out being an eggnog, you know. Turn and turn, here we go. I still don't understand it though, that football should have been on, it's weird. Why is the football not on? I want to join chat. Oh dear. Not join chat, join that. I mean, you can... I can't remember if we allow, like, randomers to join, or if it's only League Racers. I know for a fact that League Racers at least have priority to join. But I mean, you can try and go on the website on the Project Cars section and the social events things and see what it says. And well, you can just use this post for the Dubai. It's the same post every week. And see what it says there. I'm actually not sure. I can go check it afterwards. After the knick-knock. Honestly, what is this bitch? Oh, the practice session. Well, AJ don't like other people because we've been having problems with other people from this league even. That don't know how to drive a fucking car and kept trying to defend and stuff, and like seeing as he's an actual lead driver, he's very much into all that thing, so he don't want. I'm lucky to be there. Oh, Nick Nagari. Yeah, but the thing is, yeah, I feel like AJ wouldn't allow anyone to be in there anyway, so. Oh god, need to break there. Game, stop being evil. But honestly, this track is just bad. Like, seriously, this track is perfect for touring cars, like front wheel driven touring cars. Where you can just fly into the cones and just let the rear step out and just fly through, especially first sector. Yeah, I feel like he wouldn't like that. I mean, that honestly, there's a few people allowed to actually be there. It's almost like a private session when the actual race team are testing the cars and stuff. You don't want people to see things. And the thing is, if someone should happen to crash by instant, even if I crash by an accident, like, let's say I spun up in this last corner here, and I didn't have time to get out of the way, he would still get mad at me. Oh, forever long. I don't know, are you getting F1 2016? Because there should be a leak set up for that as well, probably. There's an interest thread going right now on the forum, on the AOR forums.
I hear that corner.
So yeah. Because I'm thinking I might get F1 2016, I'm not gonna pre-order it. I'm gonna wait and see what people actually say, because F1 2015 was hyped as fuck as well, and well, we all know what happened to that game. Like, what was it, the multiplayer didn't work, and yeah, nothing really worked. But I like that we're gonna be able to have full qualifying sessions though. Not sure it's a good idea for the league race though. I'm currently too busy with, yeah. I mean, it's a lot of games. Like, the thing is, if I keep racing GT and the Formula Renault, or Formula V8 as it's called now, when it comes back, and the F1, that's gonna be three different leagues. Or three different, go away fly. That's gonna be three different cars in three different leagues technically. And like the F1 race is probably gonna be on Sunday. Don't know when there's gonna be a social for that. Might be either Saturday or Thursday or some shit. So that's gonna be, well, at least a race Sunday. Then the Formula Renault should probably be on Mondays. Then on Tuesdays we have the GT social races. Did we ever? I don't think we had social races for the Formula Renault. But yeah, then on Monday we have the Formula Renault, then on Tuesday we have the GT social, Then on Wednesday we have the GT race, then Thursday might be a social for the F1 games, and yeah. It's gonna be banned. If the game does well, I will. Yeah, exactly the same. It depends on the game. Because if the game is the same quality as Codemasters usually deliver, I actually can't be asked to waste money on it.
For God's sake.
Meow. Oh, you left the session.
No, I hate this track.
Nah, it would be so much more fun with front-wheel driven touring cars, though.
Yeah, I'd like it on like some like, a Radical or something. That'd be better.
Yeah, that would be fun as well. I like it in Great Old Sport with the touring cars.
Yeah, I don't know why we haven't got a Radical League on a PC, to be honest.
I mean, you could try and set one up. Maybe just people are just not setting it up because there's too much effort.
Maybe, yeah.
Just make it one of those interest spreads and see if people actually want it.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I might give that a go.
I feel like you should.
Anyway, I'll see you tomorrow. Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow, guys.
Ciao.
So that was Hamish. That was the first car we were supposed to be battling. That's gone now. Then we have Corners or whatever it's called.
You on that head. You just lose the rear end.
No, go on, what? That black part over there, I always think that's a car. I don't know why. Just whenever I see something that looks a bit black, I always just assume it's gonna be a car. Stop going sideways, car. One of the coolest, not. What the fuck is this tire wear? Jesus. I mean, I might have gone sideways a few times, but still. 23 on the left, that's insane. Hey, Iceman. What should you in? I feel like this is definitely the reason why I had this much tire. I'm just drifting all over the place half the time. Hey, Iceman, what are you doing today? Well, apart from watching my stream, apparently. Stupid curves. Nope, stupid curves. Nope, please. I don't like this track. Actually, I like this track just with all the cars. Community race? What community race? What are you talking about, right? Yay, watching my stream. I wanna watch my stream. I should watch my stream more. Actually, I'm usually watching it after the race when I'm uploading it over to YouTube. Thank you later for my amazing idea. What idea? I'm confused. Wildcard community race. Oh god, no, what? I don't know. What are you talking about? I'm confused. Why is there yellow flags everywhere? Seriously, I'm serious, I'm about to get lapped soon though. I'm gonna get lapped. By the end of this lap something. What do you mean community race? You mean like if I host a session and then yeah. Nah, the last guy charity race. That's what it should be instead. Then we could save up money for some charity thing. That would actually be a funny idea. Imagine if I was actually a big streamer on this game on Project Cars. Then we could have like a charity event where you could like pay someone to be allowed to drive in the game with me or something. Man, you should watch out for the infamous, yeah. Yeah, I mean if he invades it's fine, I don't care about him. he's gonna come here and make blocks. That's what he does. I can just go ban all things that says quiff or queef. It would actually be that simple, just tell Nutbot anything that says that is gonna get banned. Oh, brake damage, oh no, oh dear. So apparently my front left brake is starting to get destroyed for some fucking reason. But yeah, imagine a charity stream, that would actually be fun sec. If I get some people, nah, right, it's not bot blocks, it's just queef and his fucking blocks all the time. Yeah, I mean I would ban, but that means I need to pick up to the pit to ban. Because I can't really like tap out of the game in the middle of a race. Well, then I would have to park, but I definitely don't want to do that. Even though I don't really care that much, like, it's not going to be depending on how many cars there's going to be left. I'm not sure if I'm going to be driving the entire race distance. Because it is fucking far to drive 40 laps. Ugh. How is the tire this big? Seriously, what is this Nicknoggery? What is this wizardry? Oh, yeah. See you later, Iceman. Enjoy your day, or night, or something. Enjoy, indeed. But yeah, the thing is, a lot of the drivers just tend to like leave either halfway through or after the first stint. Like, before they pit the first time, because they tested what they need to test, so there's not that much point of staying. I feel like this tower is insane though. Might just be me. I don't know that shit. You German engine. Yeah, German. Even though I'm not German, but close enough. But yeah, German engine. I mean the roof. The roof. Kind of like a Porsche, just without the Porsche, but you know, it's a roof. There we go. Once these left tires, I'm thinking about actually putting mediums on or some shit, just to test it. I'm actually tending them to pit right now and see. There we go. And going straight. Yeah, exactly. These tires are not good enough for drifting. I need some drift tires on this Nick Nugget. You can just hear them screeching. Why are they screeching all the time, Sister? What's wrong with them? Honestly, these tires are bad. Yay, Danish! Jawohl! Why am I speaking German when I'm Danish? Because it's something we learned in school for some stupid ass reason. Because, yeah, apparently Germany is our biggest like trade partner thing, so we need to learn German. I don't know why. Why can't they just fucking learn to learn English instead? Like, one of the other drivers, he's not here tonight, Beppo. Yeah, he's German. He can actually speak English. And a lot of the drivers that think German can speak English. Why can't they just learn to speak English? Honestly, it's bullshit. Danish sounds funny. No, it doesn't. I can say things in English. Well, I mean, of course I can. I'm Danish, so. That's kind of my thing. I love to speak Danish. It's funny. Just not a lot of people want to watch Danish things. Because the thing is that Denmark is such a small country, so there's not a lot of people to watch it. And Norwegian and Sweden can people from Sweden are Norwegian. That's a flight. That's a company for flying things. Because English is from England, which is not part of the EU. That's because they're knickknacks. Yeah, last time I was on the podium, England was still in the EU. That's actually true, though. Honestly, I haven't been on the podium since season 1 of this Necknoggery, and that was when the game just came out. That's like fucking ages ago. I mean, at least I'm still not getting lapped, at least. I just want to see how far I can take it with this tire before it actually starts to be a fucking problem. Why are the tires? What's wrong with them? I'm German and I can speak English. 9, 9, 9. That's impossible. Germans can't speak English.
Closely
packed. I'm sure when you're writing English right now, it's actually just German, but it's just Twitch automatically translating it, I feel like.
Ooh.
But honestly, right, like, do you know some German people that like go to like a vacation house up in Denmark on the west coast somewhere or something? Because like my parents have a house up in on the western coast, and it's pretty much Germans all the time, and that's a dog in the background. Ruff, ruff. 9, 9, 9. But yeah, they have a house out there, and it's usually Germans like renting the house and stuff. And the thing is, if we come out there and there's still some Germans out there, they just automatically speak German. Everywhere they're just speaking German. I don't understand. They're in Denmark, why are you speaking German? It's fucking Necknoggery, that's what it is. My brother lives in Flensburg. Not close enough, like my uncle used to live in Flensburg. Because it's way too cheaper for a Dane to live in Germany and just drive over the border each day if he works close enough to the border. So yeah, actually a lot of people do that. They live like just down in Germany a bit and then just drive to Denmark. Or live in Sweden as well, because that's still cheaper. Oh god, P1, that looks like khaki. Oh no, khaki stairway. But yeah, I can really start to feel my tires are dying, but I just want to see how far I can take them. I've been to Flensburg quite often. Well, actually, recently as well. Oh, trying this 2x tower game. Oh god, what is this thing already? But yeah, I've actually been to Flensburg quite often because, you know, what's it called? The stores that you buy like candy and sodas and beer and shit in. That's where all the Danes come. That's down to close to Flensburg, but if I'm not much mistaken. What's it called? Is it Flecko, I think it's called? One of them? Or Fleckgard, you might call them, I don't know what you call them in German. But yeah, there's one of those like big stores where you come and buy alcohol and shit. Cheap alcohol for Danes. Well, actually not that cheap anymore, it used to be way cheaper. It's a city, it rains all the fucking time. Yeah. That's because it's close to Denmark. That's why it rains all the time. Because it rains all the time in Denmark as well. Well, I see people in the pits. He's actually in the pit. Cocky coming to lap me at a 15 accent? That's kind of normal. That's not so bad, considering how many accents I had so far and penalties. I can live with that. I don't know why, for some reason I feel like my tires are breaking better when they're warm. As soon as we get out on a bit straight-ish area, I need to see the lap times. Actually, I'm gonna do one more lap, I think. Fly, piss off, you fucking imbecile. Let me see the knickknacks. I can just go inside. There he was. A wild cocky appeared behind me and in front of me. Dude, his what? Oh god, Ty's dead. Too late to pit, need to take another lap then. It rained during his swearing in 70. What? His what ceremony? What? Swearing in? What? What swearing in ceremony? What? Swearing, what? What do you mean swearing in? Oh, my tires just died completely, they did. What's a swearing in ceremony? I can't speak anymore now. And my tires don't work anymore either. Oh god, my tires definitely dead. I can feel it on the wheel even. Oh, it's the other thing for the army, nice. Oh, he's in the, what's he doing in the army? Is he like, actual army or air force or anything? Or? No! Force you back, shut up! You just see the cars that it's smoking the most because the tire's just dead. But actually, it's pretty impressive I can go for this far considering the knickknacks I've been doing. I'm actually quite happy. I feel like I can one-stop this, probably. Depending on how things go, of course, and crashes and damage and all kind of funny things, you know. Navy officer, nice. The German Navy, yeah. Too bad we don't have that giant Bismarck anymore. Don't mention the war. At least this is cool. No, I hit this pit entry. Why is that chicane right there? Seriously. Yep, that's the right setup. Just go. Navy officer, at least that's his goal. Nice. Yeah, the Reichsmarine, that was the word I was looking for. I couldn't remember it. I might go to the Danish Navy or something, even though I don't really understand why, because we have like stupid useless ships. We have like frigates and they're just bad. But it's the education I'm taking is that like basically a marine engineer, basically. So I'm the mechanic on the ship thing. The thing is when we're done we can actually go to the Navy if we're lucky to get a spot, of course. There's only that many people that can go, of course, so. And I'm just going to lap by him. Actually, where's AJ? Where the fuck is AJ? I don't see him. Oh, he's third. Nice. That's Axe. Your pace is steady, but you'll need to push a bit harder to catch the field. Come on, you can do this. Let's try and get a better set on this one. Why are you giving me blue flags? There's no blue flag. He's looking for some sort of engineer to get. Is he working down, or wanting to work down the engine room thingy, or? That's all I want to know, really. Hell if I know what exactly. Because if he wants to work down in the engine room, then it's basically the same as I'm doing.
Beautiful.
Even though I'm not on a ship right now, so I'm just land-based right now. But I would like to go on like a Danish ship because they don't go that far away. And I wouldn't want to go on a container ship or anything like that because that's honestly too much effort. Because you're so far away and it's just so
just
long at a time.
Hit this lap to try and undercut him.
Well,
don't
need to know.
So yeah, that's the problem.
Brakes are
But yeah, the thing is that, like, I'm 26. By the time I'm done being educated, I'm probably like, what, 28 or something? I wouldn't want to do anything with ships. I hate the water. Wow, what's wrong with you? You're bad. Water's awesome. I love water. I mean, if I could live in water, I would do it. Honestly. But yeah, the thing is that I'm going to be like around 28 when I'm done with my education. And if I don't, let's say I have a girlfriend at that time, maybe think about like getting an actual wife instead of a girlfriend, you know, and stuff, and the kids and all kind of stuff. Then it just doesn't make any sense to me that I am going to be away for like 3 months at a time and then be home for a month and then 3 months again. Honestly, yeah, that just wouldn't work for me. And that's why, oh, that would be mean in black, nice. And that is why a lot of people, they take the education to go sailing, then they sail for like the 3 years they have in the contract, getting paid shit ton of money, and then they're gonna retire from sailing and go back to actually being on land. See, maybe that can catch me. I'm just breaking a bit of it just to make sure I don't hit the table or anything useful like that. Seriously, Tibble, you're turning way too much on that corner. And that was an upturn.
I've got 900 degree brakes, can't slow down.
Rip Tibble. Not quite sure how our Navy does it, to be honest. Does what? Oh yeah, you mean like how far they away at a time? I don't think it's that bad with the Navy, to be honest. It's worse with the with like the cargo carriers, like mask and whatever they're all called. Wow, everyone is trying to go for long runs, I see on the tires. I went in hit way earlier than these McNuggets. And you see they were just starting to slide around all of them right now. I can't wait to see what AJ is saying is gonna be the optimal time. For a little pit. A pit put. Look at how many is in the pit right now. It's 5th, 4th, all the way up to 4th place. I'm unlapping myself. Wow. The thing is, this corner, I just want to drift through these corners right here and I don't want to go out there. But yeah, I feel like the Navy is still going to be quite a while, of course, depending on where you're going, what kind of ship you're on, of course, but it's probably still going to be a few months or something, but yeah. And then when you're home, you're probably going to be in training most of the time, I think. Whereas if you're in like on a container ship or just a or tanker thing, then you're going to be out for a couple of months and then you're going to be home and actually be off the job for a month or something, or some weeks. Which would be awesome as well, because like imagine you're gone for 3 months, then you have 1 month off job. You just have 1 month to just be yourself and just enjoy yourself. But of course, there's a lot of things you can't do because you're gone for so much of the year. So like, just imagine like if you have a family, like, yeah, that wouldn't work for me at least. I mean, it works for some people, but then I would prefer to have a job like on a local ferry just in Denmark,
nice. Retire book.
Denmark, England or something. Well, hey, chosen man, I'll just do whatever suits me. Yeah, actually, what do you want to do? What do you want to do in your life? Which is being a nerd. Yes, you can always just do some coding, like get a job coding things. That was Mini Black leaving the session.
See you tomorrow, guys.
So yeah, that was Mini Black leaving the session. He had the wet tire bug, which is sometimes when you pit, you get wet rain tires on, which is always fun, of course. I love getting wet rain tires on. Oh, that would be 19th. Yeah, I did the undercut and the knickknack. I'm such a good driver. Actually, I'm not, but you know. I started coding. Tried my hand at it. I feel like you just need to find something that you actually would enjoy coding, like something that actually interests you. And then you would do that, and then you would actually get good at it, and then you could actually start doing it usefully. Actually got a place on this. The undercut worked. Not a lot. Well, actually, it was quite a lot. I was like 10, 15 seconds behind him. So that's actually I'm quite happy with that. Of course, I have all the tires now, and he can probably go to the end. I probably can't. And exactly not when I'm going like that. Let me get into forensic analysis. Oh dear. That actually sounds fucking cool. That actually sounds so fucking cool. Like, I've always, originally, like when I was a kid-ish, until I was like, what, 12, 13, 14, I wanted to be like, something doctor-ish, something like that. And I actually had the grades for it, but then I couldn't be asked anymore. And then I dropped all my grades, and then now I can't be a doctor. And I feel like just when I think back at it, I wouldn't want to be a doctor anyway, like honestly. But something forensic analysis, that would be sick. Yeah, yeah, I know what it means. I've been thinking about that because that would be so fucking cool. That was my idea when I wanted to be like a doctor or something. Back when I was really young and actually had good grades and were doing well in school. I really wanted to be something like that, and that was exactly what I wanted to be like. I was always watching those programs on TV. And it's just, I just feel like it's such a fake idea you get of it by watching that thing, those things. I mean, sure, sometimes it's gonna be one of those things where it's just like a TV, but sometimes it's just not gonna be like that, and you're just gonna be annoyed. Toxicology, oh dear. That would be sick as well. I would probably be like a sports doctor thingy, and then give people doping just for the bands. Like, imagine being the one responsible for all of Tour de France being doped. You would make so much money on it. I feel like he's gonna be trying to dive bomb me. Nah, it's honestly, if you ever watch Superbad, if you remember the cops in Superbad, oh god. Like, they're talking about like crime scenes at some point, and they're just like saying something like they expected there to be semen on everything. That's honestly what I'm thinking. Like, when you watch those programs, it's just... I'm a hobby silence myself. Oh dear, you're drunk. Not drunk, you're on drugs. Nah, I feel like you would be on not steroids, what they're called. EPO thing, whatever it's called, EPO, whatever it's called, the knick-knock things. I mean, they all are it, they're all doing it anyway, so... Honestly, what's the problem? Oh, don't want to go wild. Safety then, now it's time for drink.
Okay, you've got good, consistent pace, and you're gonna need to pick it up a bit, then push
on. Why are my brakes suddenly working way too good? Do I actually limit team maybe instead of me? Yeah, definitely. But yeah, honestly. I feel like everyone is in the Tour de France is fucking doped, honestly. Let's be real here, or realistic or something. That was so cool. That was so cool of him just waving past us or through us, you know. I feel like the next guy's probably gonna want that position very soon as well. I don't know. Oh, that's AJ. I feel like, yeah, AJ just got left through, I feel like. No. Most at least are dope. Yeah, exactly. They're fucking knickknacks. All of them. Yeah, it's just AJ, my little friend AJ, my teammate. Well, technically not my teammate, but you know. He's my teammate, he's on my sister team, or mother team, whatever you want to call it. He's on the sister team up in the elite. I'm the leader of the pro team, he's in the leader of the elite team. Have you seen those people, a guy my size at 190 centimeters, has a maximum weight, maybe 85 to 90 kilo if I work, something like that. Kill them on muscle strength. Oh dear, what? I just feel like if you're 190 and you're weighing like 85 to 90 kilos, then you're not gonna be that buffed actually when you think about it. Because like what, I'm not that tall, I'm what, 175 or some shit, I'm like small. And I weigh around 80 kilos because I'm just fat. And I'm just thinking muscles weigh more than fat, so yeah. I don't know. I would still like to be dope, that would be funny. That would be dope, so to speak. That was a nice line I did then. If it's all Marvel, you'll be buff. Yes. Yes. I'm just thinking, like weight wise, it just doesn't make sense to only weigh 85 to 90 kilos if you're that tall. It might just be that because I feel like I'm fat when I look at myself. Not exactly like, not obese fat, but just overweight ish. Because I'm 80 kilos and 175 centimeters tall. I'm just thinking like 90 kilos and 190 tall. Oh, and I need to break. I need to stop talking and break. Yeah, I don't even know. Seriously, my tie wear insane. It's Nick Nuggery. Kaki just left, nice. Stephanie wants to go, dear. I feel like there's gonna be porn pics coming soon. We need a bit of porn in this thing. We need some porn in this stream, even though that's not allowed according to Twitch, so no porn on Twitch. I would never do that. We would never do that, no porn. Ain't nobody got time to watch porn here. I mean, like Desko would probably be watching porn like that. MTU and RH thing, fucking Danish Nick Knock. He's watching porn all the time, that's what he does. He's like watching hentai and shit. It's a fucking cool night. Come on, AJ, you need to fucking move your fat ass, you're too slow. I wonder if he's trying to make the overcut thing or something. That was a blue car going wide. Who the fuck was that? I couldn't even see that car. Why? What? Oh, we got a penalty! I love getting penalties. Actually, no, I don't. I love it when other people get penalties. And that coin has just... Coin has just caught me so fucking fast. This is Nick Nuggery. Oh, come on, car. I want to see how far I can take this car. I feel like the tire is way higher right now than it was before. I mean, you know, it's just sagging around, so... I feel like AJF changed a lot of the setup. So wait, can I find the lab when I actually put it on my lap timer? Nope, I can't. RIP. Weird. Fuck it.
Yeah.
Going around the corners like a Nick now. Don't want to go wide there. I feel like I might have been a bit wide, but actually I don't really care like right now. It's all just Nick Nuggery. Oh, I'm getting faster. Cars catching up to me fast right now. Oh dear. Oh dear indeed. Oh dear indeed. I hope I can wait to let them pass out onto one of the straights, or hopefully the main straight. And though I feel like the next car is definitely going to catch me before that. I mean, it depends on how well I drive and how well he drives, of course. Is that Blue Rat? No, that's Hideaki, and I can't see who the blue guy is.
Thanks, last guy.
Yeah, you're welcome. Tony, could you please stop extending all the time?
Okay, I'm out. See
you
guys.
See ya. Yes, Drift King, Drift King. I'm the Drift King of this game, seriously. I should get a medal for all my nice drifting. Yeah, I feel like most of the people are probably gonna start leaving right about now, so... Like, when everybody starts leaving, I'm gonna leave as well. Because honestly, there's no point of just driving around alone on this track. You know... Nick Nuggery, Nick Nuggery. But yeah, right, I'll definitely go check if you're allowed to be signing up for the race. And I'll definitely... You need to remind me when I'm leaving the game. Because I'm probably going to forget it again. I mean, I probably already forgot it now. I'm going to write that. I'll read that very soon, as soon as I got a chance to actually come out on the straight or something to read it. Okay, right now I'm at 85 kilo and about 10% body fat. Nice. Yeah, I feel like I'm about 100% body fat. Really don't need to race, I just don't want to practice alone. Oh yeah. I'm gonna check the race, I can check after the race, I can check the social, what it says on the social page. I'm not sure, I remember there's some red writing somewhere on it, but, you know. Right now, I'm also at the healthiest I've ever been. Yeah, I don't really give a shit right now, like, to be honest. I mean, as long as I'm not, like, that completely, like, obese, I actually don't care that much. Like, I mean, I should probably lose a little bit of weight, but honestly, like, meh. It's all Nick Nuggery, you know. Your lap times are a little bit inconsistent. Like, honestly, yeah, I don't care. I just, like, I'm just controlling my weight right now, actually, like. I've been steady at 80 kilos for the past, like, what, 5 years or something, I think. Like, pretty much all the fucking time. After a point when I was weighing at 100 kilos, so. And I decided it would probably be the best to not be 100 kilos because that's way too much for anyone my height. Let's get out here on the street and see. To their own, to each their own, exercising helps me do. Yeah, exactly. I mean, I'm lucky I haven't really had any depression-ish kind of thing, so yeah. But yeah, exercise would definitely also help me in like daily life, just getting more energy and stuff like that. Andrew, I'm gonna be wide down here in this corner, so go on the inside line past me. Yeah, I see.
Orange McLaren, yeah.
No. Wow, that Mercedes is slow on the street. I'm gonna stay wide central.
Nice.
Oh, slow accelerating Mercedes.
Actually, probably he's just lagging.
No, actually, it's not really lagging. His car was fine. Yeah, exercise would definitely help a lot of people. Like, I mean, at some point I didn't really do any exercise at all, and I could just feel after I started, like, just simple things like just walking a bit, like walking those, like, what, 10,000 thingies a day. Simple things like that actually helped me a lot, like having more energy on a daily basis, and like in school as well. Seriously, is that Tony getting penalties again? Honestly, Tony, you need to stop doing that. What the fuck am I doing? I feel like I'm starting to feel bad for this corner guy behind me. Every fucking time he gets close to me, what happens? Someone comes to lap him and he needs to give them space. And I luckily managed to make sure they overtake me at some point where I actually want to be overtaken and I can easily avoid them and not lose too much time. Come on, let's catch these knickknacks in front. I mean, I still have 30 seconds up to the next car in front of me, so I don't really care that much, like, honestly. I just want to just, it's actually just tire wear testing right now. I feel like this is definitely too much tire wear. Thing is, I can go until they're around 40 and they're 31 and 28 on the left side right now. No. That's race strategy, too. So too bad for him. What's race strategy? Oh, you mean me, like me trying to avoid making them overtake me at the specific points? Yeah. I mean, I always do that. If I see someone behind me, like I see these two knobs coming down here, I'm gonna try and make sure they're not gonna get close enough to overtake me until after we get out to another good place. And then, if not, then I'm at least gonna pretend I'm gonna be fighting them. Just look like blue ride on someone else. Yeah, definitely blue ride on someone else. The thing is, Blue Rider is driving with probably the similar setup to me, and him and me, we're often very close to the same pace, so, like, actual race pace. So I'm just gonna be a bit of a bitch. You're welcome.
Nice to see you again.
No, I'm gonna crash you off soon. I need to crash someone off. Where's AJ? Actually, yeah, I remember I promised AJ. He promised me I was allowed to crash him off tonight. I need to find him. I should probably slow down at some point. That was a nice slow car. Rip him. I feel like he got a penalty or something, or trying to leave the game, I don't know what the fuck. Come on, Drift King, Drift King, Drift King, Drift King. Nice drift. Actually, I feel like it's more power slide really when I'm doing it. And luckily I'm Mr. Corner's thing behind me is having to fight with a lapping car, so that's nice. That's always good for me. Always good for me indeed. No, 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 no mics allowed.
It's blue right, I think.
What's up?
You were hot micing.
But yeah, I definitely used to try and do that on my race strategies, like trying getting lapped at the good points of the track and not the bad points. And like, I'm just like, the rule says I'm actually not supposed to be deciding when I want to people to overtake. But I still do it all the time anyways. Because like also the lapping cars also want to, it's nice for them to know that I know they're coming and I'm actually planning when they're supposed to be leaving or not leaving, go past, you know. Like now you can see I'm getting the blue flag again and I'm not gonna give him that spot. Like some people just go to the side here and let them pass. Even though they're this far behind, I'm gonna wait out until the straight. And then he can just slipstream past me and I don't need to lose time on this nickname. And I mean, if you can't slipstream it, then I'm just gonna give some, make some worse breaking down in the braking zone, so. Wow, his car's low. What is this nickname doing? But as you can see, then I'm just gonna be going wide a bit. And stay out here, stay out here. Wow, that was useless. But see, here I actually had to break off, otherwise we would have went too wide into this corner. But other than that, I just try and generally stay as close as I can. And he's extending, nice. I wonder if I can get some slipstream on him. I feel like I'm too far away. And I didn't get that good a run out on the straight either, so, you know. Perfect line. Almost cutting the corner, but not really cutting it. Come on, nice and steady, and then power. Power! Exactly how we should do it. But yeah, I like to be the one in control of when they're gonna be getting it past me, unless, of course, they're just fast enough to actually overtake me. But often, even the fastest drivers, naturally they're faster, but as soon as they get close, they're gonna lose some of that speed because they can't go their normal lines. They need to evade me and my slowness, so yeah. But often I find like big wide corners like this and give them room in and look at that drift in the background. As you can see now, Mr. Corners behind us is getting lapped again by two more cars. And I actually think these two cars are fighting for position, so. And why are there more brake markers missing, seriously? Honestly, how can people just not stop destroying those brake markers? It's fucking bullshit. I honestly don't understand why. Seriously, what's wrong with them? And that looked like a car crash. That was definitely a blue car crash down there. Rip. Nice sideways, come on, give us some sideways action here. Oh, a stupid car. Why don't I want to drift when I do? What is this? Nick Nowry. Yeah, drifter. Exactly. We need some drifting. I'm not that good at drifting cars though. But honestly, this is bad because right now the pit stop is, I need to pit again. With my current tire wear, so that's a bit of some bullshit. Need to talk to Fenton or AJ and see if he changed anything to the setup, you know. Because you can see with all that smoke on my car is making right now, that just means that it's about to die. Fuck it, I don't know if I'm gonna drive the rest of the race with this or what I wanna do. But you can just see, seriously, it's just going sideways all the time. Oh, that's terrible, oh dear. Terrible, I'm going wide down here. Honestly, I don't know what's wrong with Tibble today. I feel like his tires are just dead today. I don't know why, his car's just feeling so slow today. Oh, that's a kind of pit. That's Dinette in the pit. Oh dear. I feel like either he retired or he's just pitting for more tires. I don't know. So why can't we be allowed to look over the pit wall? But yeah, I'm definitely going to be needing another pit stop if this keeps going like this, because my tires are way too much tire wear right now. Oh god, that was brake damage. Three of my brakes just went red right there. Because we have the mechanical failures on this season, so yeah, the brakes are actually going to be worn as well, and as you can see, the tires are worn as well, everything is worn. And like my front left and front right brakes are pretty much dead, like gone. I mean, they look pretty in there. No setup tire. That's another thing with my force feedback setting, is I can hear when my tire wear is getting very bad. So yeah, I can start to hear that force feedback rattling because the tires are bad, so that's always fun. No, don't want to go sideways. Scratched a little bit. I'm not sure if I should actually pit or not. I feel like I should. I'm gonna go for the pit, just for the bands. Like honestly, I don't even care about the positions right now in this race, I just want to simulate it. And I need some stats on how long it takes to do a pit stop, so it's always nice to do more. My damage breaks are absolutely wrecked. How's the car reacting right here? Ah, car feels fine. Let's take another lap just for the bands. I mean, I honestly don't care about like positions, so it doesn't really matter if we just keep going for fun or not. Oh, drift king. A bit wide, don't give me penalties. Yay! No penalties. I'm so glad I didn't get penalties. Shut the fuck up, wheel. Honestly. That's another problem with me doing the stick shift, is that I don't have a hand on the wheel when I'm drinking, so... No penalty! No penalty for Ronaldo. Oh, the car's feeling nice for a few laps, though. I feel like this is the ultimate lap you can do, and I've got lap once, I do believe, so... Shut up! Yeah, honestly, Project Cars is about as consistent as the stewards in F1. No? Oh, I'm so wasted. Honestly, my tires are so fucking dead right now. Am I Max Verstappen for any chance? Yeah, actually I am. I'm definitely back Max Verstappen. I'm definitely Dutch right now. Yes! Don't worry, pit crew, I will go to the box. Oh, I hit this pit. Fuck it. I'm gonna take the alternative pit exit. Or pit entry, actually. That's the alternative way to get to the pit, but seeing as we don't have damage on right now, I don't really care. But wow, my tower is way too high right now, honestly. Still weird I can't find that lap when I pitted last time. Weird. I don't know what it is, for bullshit. Lap 36 is what I'm playing around. Well, technically, oh, I see now. Of course, there should be one stow lab around there somewhere. I can't find it, fuck it. Yeah, that's the way you should take the pit entry. Like, why is that wall there? Why is that wall in the middle of the pit entry, honestly? It's fucking stupid. I need some windscreen wipers down the bottom. Come on, game. And some lights. And some other knickknacks. Don't care about them. Fuck them. Fuck the other cars. Okay, I can shut up with the vibe, I don't like it. Annoying. Come on, game. I believe in you. So I need to get better at expanding my stand a bit. Thinking how I can do that. I can change the tire wears a bit, maybe. Because honestly, right now I don't want to have to pit two times. Like seriously, that's bullshit. I actually don't know what car is that behind me. Who's that? Oh, it's Raikkonen in first place, oh dear. Oh dear indeed, what a knick-knock. It's the first place, that means Svensson is close to them. That means Svensson is actually close. I need to know if I can crash him off. Oh, he's so far away, I can't be lost. And you can get past on the straight if you're fast enough in your little blue ugly roof. If you're not that, then it's just tough luck. Tough luck indeed. Oh, honestly, I missed those black marks down there. Oh, Drift King, Drift King, Drift King. There we go, out on straight again. Can you catch me, Mr. Roof? Mr. Rygor Roof, can you catch me? No, you cannot catch me because I'm the master of straights.
Central.
What?
It's funny that he can't make it past. Honestly, it's so funny.
Sorry, get here.
There you go. Let him go. I don't care. That must mean AJ is the next one, and they should be on. I should be lap 2 times now, I think. So if I'm lap 2 times, that means they're on lap 38. I need to have some fun with AJ when he gets it. Fly, piss off! Stop sitting on my wall. Stop sitting on my wheel as well. I swear to God. Seriously, nah, these flies are bullshit. They keep landing on my phone monitor. It's so annoying. At least they've not been landing on my hand that much this much tonight. I feel like that's gonna be AJ down there. Is that AJ? It definitely looked like AJ in second. Looked like second place, and I'm assuming that's AJ, so. I'm hoping it's AJ, because then I need to touch him. I need to crash him out. So they're going on to 39 now, would be my guess. Oh, that definitely looks like AJ. That definitely looks like a roof the same colors of mine. That's the thing, if all my team, like we used to be 3 drivers, right now we're only 2 because one moved down to the semi-pros. But if we were all 3 from my team and all 3 from the elite, then we'd be 6 cars here with the same skin. And I'm rather sure there's a team down in the semi-pros that drive with the same skin, actually. So they're on 39 right now. And I'm on 37. Oh god, my pedals are starting to slide. But please not. Please no. I'm a big fan of my pedals not sliding. Come on, AJ, catch me, you fucking knick-knock. Wow, he's slow. He's slow today. Honestly, I need to get my pedals relocated a bit. There we go. That should be better. That was my braking pedal that started sliding a bit. Well, that definitely looks like AJ. Interesting, this. What's interesting? Did I say something funny or interesting? I'm just chatting shit half the time. Just talking to myself, mostly. I'm used to just chatting shit. I've been surrounded by AJ for so long, I'm just used to chatting shit all the time. I mean, he's a United fan, so he's not that bright. He's not the brightest tool in the shed, something. I don't know. So they're going on to the final lap right now, aren't they? Let's see. Yep, they're in that 40 out of 40. I feel like he don't want to come and overtake me. I feel like he wouldn't. He's scared. And he's probably going to start pitching when I hit him off as well. But he said in our Steam chat that we were allowed to crash each other off, so. Yeah, he's seen me. Yeah. What a fucking cunt, mate. Oh, my knick-knack. Oh, I'm such a nick. Oh, he just spun! He spun! Oh, he might get overtaken by someone. Please say he's not. That way it could be so much fun. Oh, I feel like he is! Oh, is that who's gonna be second? Oh, wait, he's still got second! I mean, he told me I could do it. Not my fault. His fault. That's what you get from saying I'm allowed to crash you off. Look at that sandwich that Pan dude is in right now. He's gonna be mad. Yep, he is. I'm just waiting for him to ride right now. Oh, for God's sake, I couldn't resist it. I actually couldn't. Well, we have 2 minutes before all cars are called back. Look at my windscreen wiper.
Push me out of the way.
But while that goes, I'm just gonna go on the forum and check what it said in that message thing. Come on, game, please now. Get over here. No, I need to go on the forums. Slow forum. Let's go check the community thread thing. The Nicknoggery. Oh, let's go to page one, play. There we go. La la la. Due to increased numbers, only drivers placed in the league can sign up. Yeah, only. So it's only league drivers, sadly, right? Only league drivers can actually sign up for the race. Feels bad, man. Yeah, it's only league races then, so. But we're probably gonna have some special events, just check that social section every now and again. There's probably gonna be tons of social events and stuff like that. At some point, at least. Or you could just go in and post one and say, and you. Did my AI just crash AJ off again? Wow, what the fuck is my AI doing? Oh, my AI just crashed off AJ. Oh, that was funny. I love crashing a AJ. Yeah, you might get lucky with the social. The thing is, right now, all the social races, at least in the GT, is strictly for all the league drivers only. But basically, because we have like 3 full leagues, and we had some incidents before with Nick Knox, so you know. So yeah, the problem is we had some problems with people that joined up in the social and just honestly didn't know how to drive and just assumed it was like a honest normal open lobby and just crashed into everything. So that was kind of bullshit as well. What a fucking nicknock, mate. I need to save this replay. Woohoo, podium! It is right now. 3 full leagues, yeah, pretty much 3 full leagues with, 26 drivers in each, I think it is? Yeah, we used to only have 2 leagues, but now we have the pro, elites, the pro and the semi-pro. Surely because of the number of sign-ups, and I think there's like 6 reserves for the semi-pro, 2 reserves for the pros, and a couple, 2 as well for the elites or something. So honestly, yeah, that's how it is. That's how many we are. Yeah, funny, there was no crashes in the pitching tonight. Oh, for God's sake. I'm just gonna go. Let's just leave this. I'm just gonna go mute the TeamSpeak for a second and start the stream. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, Shut Up TeamSpeak. Thank you so much for watching the stream tonight. I'm gonna be streaming again tomorrow at, 8 p.m. UK time. So yeah, see you next time. Bye-bye.